Hello, boating world. This is Martin Boyer with Austin Boats and Motors, bringing you a video of a 2018 Ranger 212 LS Reata. This boat here is shown in the 50th anniversary color scheme. Very attractive boat. Not going to be hard on the water spots with the silver hull sides. Be a boat to keep relatively clean easily. It's featured with the Ranger trailer. Of course, they're known for their own custom trailers. They build those in-house. You notice here you've got the step up to make it easy to get from the boat ramp up into the boat. Belly-mounted center spare tire. Tandem axle trailer with fiberglass fenders that Ranger's been known for years. Upgraded wheels and tires on this particular model. We've got ratchet style tie downs here in the back to make it easy to get the boat ready to trailer and to keep secure on the trailer when you're going down a highway. This particular boat is featured with the Verado Pro supercharged 250 horsepower inline six four stroke. Has built-in power steering to make it very easy to drive and to enjoy maneuvering on the water. Don't have to strain yourself like you would with the typical hydraulic steering with a larger engine like this. You'll notice here it's featured with a Lowrance Elite in the dash. Nice tempered safety glass windshield with a walkthrough. It's got the Minn Kota Ultera, which is a breeze to operate. Comes with a foot pedal with a corded 8-foot foot control pedal, so you can steer the boat and drive and maneuver and operate it from the back of the boat if you need to, if you're trying to help kids fish. It's 80 pounds, 24 volts. It does have the iPilot feature, so you can lock it in on a spot. You'll notice new for this year, the lights are built in, so you don't have to put your bow light pole in a socket, which makes it very convenient. So your navigation lights are just built into the top deck. They're flush mounted. Take you around the other side here. This is a 21-foot, 4-inch boat. It's got an 8-foot center rod locker in it. It's got a 94-inch beam and tons of storage and tons of seating in the boat. As Ranger is known for, they always have fiberglass tooled in storage tubs built into the deck. So instead of those cheap plastic drop-in storage buckets that you'll see on competitor products that I won't mention, some start with T, some start with S. Those brands skimp out. They cut costs by cutting quality and putting cheap materials and products throughout their boats. This is where Ranger really takes it up a notch. They don't cut corners ever. You'll notice this is a gigantic aerated livewell. This is actually bigger than what's on their Pro Series bass boat product. You can divide it, but it's aerated. It's got Venturi air system in it, and does a great job of fish management. Ranger's always been known for great livewell systems. Back here, give you a view here of the bilge. Notice you got your 3-bank charger here. Charge both of your deep cycle batteries and your cranker as well. You'll notice over there in the corner, there's what we like to call a battery shutoff switch. That Blue Sea switch there has a combo feature built into it. So if you're running a little low on cranking amperage on your dedicated starting battery, you can flip the switch and it pulls in one of your deep cycle batteries off the trolling motor circuit and gives you the ability to start your engine in a weak cranking battery situation. Again, more storage in the back. Nice storage shelf back here. It's raised off the floor of this dry storage locker. And the reason they do that is to give you a place to put stuff like sandwiches, for example, or things like paper towels that you wouldn't want to be wet, because both of these dry boxes back here are also wet boxes if they're insulated. So you can put ice in them for drinks. Okay, here we've got a running rod rack. I'm kind of in the cockpit space of the boat now. You'll notice you've got a strap here to keep everything secure. Got nice tuckaway storage in the gunwale here. So if you need to store stuff away, you got plenty of storage there. We got a grab handle to hold on for safety and a nicely located cup holder, conveniently located there with then your arms reach on both sides. We have the same configuration again, cup holder, grab handle, and a storage niche there in the gunwale. You'll notice these are high back, really comfortable, deep, good lumbar support. They got wrap around sides and the seats there. These are just super comfortable seats. These seats are styled after the helm seats that the bass boats use, so they're just super comfortable. Everybody loves those seats, and you get the benefit of having these seats in the bench of this particular model. Flip up seat there to give you three across, so you have plenty of seating. Of course, this flips down like I just showed and makes a really nice, easy, integrated step. You can step right up to your back deck and get to fishing in no time. This boat has the bimini top on it. It's got the stereo, Bluetooth, Infinity, PRV 351. So you got the ability to Bluetooth stream your music. Got an Elite 9 Ti with down imaging. Full array of gauges with fuel, trim, speed, tachometer, and water pressure. Got the new membrane switches here in the cockpit now. These are really nice switches. You just push it, it lights up. You push it again, it pops back out. It's a positive switch, so there's a little click, and it does have some travel in it. So when you push it in, you can really tell you've turned it on intentionally. And when you push it again to let it out, there's a little click to let you know, and it pops back out at you. So really nice switch panel that they've upgraded to for this year. Down in here, we've got nice storage for a cell phone. We've got a cup holder here. The valve control for the livewell is also located over here near the driver's helm position. Everything fiberglass, wood free. You can see here, fiberglass tooled in foot kicks for the driver and passenger, with speakers ergonomically located on angled walls that give you good sound projection across the cockpit space. I'm gonna open up the ski locker here just to show you a couple things. Number one, we've got a mat in the floor to keep everything protected. You can store skis. You'll see we have the ski pole in here that actually stores up here in the sidewall. You can see this bracket here I'm pointing to. That actually stores away, not in the floor like we have it shown here. This is just so we can get to it easily and more quickly to demonstrate in the showroom. But it actually has a sidewall mounted bracket that it sits in, and then that non-skid pad. So you can put anything you want in here. You can put bumpers, ropes, skis, things like that. One of my favorite features on this boat is the center mounted rod box. Let me open this up for you. There we go. 8 feet rod length capability here in this storage. It's all fiberglass skin. You'll notice here we got the bungee to keep the rod butts down and secure. And then four tubes. And you can double up. You can get 8 in here. You can double up if you need to. Snap out carpet throughout the cockpit and into the bow transition area as well. You have nice storage up here. This one here, we have the cover stored away in. You've got really nice storage access in the bow. Here we have the Lowrance box and the owner's toolkit. Here we've got an ice chest built in, more of a dedicated ice chest, unlike the two in the back, which are insulated and definitely hold ice, but they're quite larger. This one's conveniently located in the bow, and it's more proportioned to a day trip. Move up to the bow here and show you this last dry storage box. There you go, fiberglass finished. It's all smooth, no shards of fiberglass in the lip. All this is ground down here where I'm running my finger. You know, most boats, this is all just rough trimmed out, but you can actually feel, or they intentionally spent some time smoothing that down. See, we have a triple seal edge here. And this seal actually has a ridge that it actually fits down into, so it's not like this is just stuck to some flat surface. This piece is actually molded on both sides, and this triple seal fits in this edge very nicely. And not saying it's waterproof, because most things on boats are not waterproof when it comes to storage anyway, but certainly water resistant, and it would keep most situations, it would keep your stuff in there very dry. Flush mount area here in the front, we can mount a 7-inch screen in this area flush, so a hook 7 or an elite 7 will fit just fine right here. Cup holder and pliers holders, conveniently located to the front of the boat here, literally within an arm's reach. Let me pan back here so you can see. There's the cockpit on the boat. Bimini top, of course, there. This is a fabulous boat if you want to get out on the water in style, ride comfortably, fish hard in the evening, fish hard in the morning, but really entertain and have something you can do some tubing or skiing with. This boat will do it all. It's very versatile. It's rated for 7 people. Let me jump out of the boat and give you a shot here of the outside one more time, just so you can get an idea of the lines. There you go. Ranger 212 Reata LS. A bargain at $54,695 starting price, plus options and engine upgrades. We have this one nicely featured, not hard loaded, but nicely featured. Again, with that 50th anniversary color scheme, this would make you a very proud boat for the family. Certainly get any kind of recreational boating done that you want to do, and it converts so easily. So you can convert it from fishing to play mode very quickly out on the water, and just a neat boat. And with that deep V, holds rough water well. Give us a call. I'm sure you got some questions on the video or just product questions in general. You can send us a message through YouTube on our video, or you can call us at 512-263-2811. You can also text that same number, and we'd be glad to get back to you with any questions you have, or if you're interested in taking a ride, reach out to one of our knowledgeable sales staff. They'd be glad to set you up with a demo and get it off the showroom floor and get it on the water so you can see what it's all about. Again, my name is Martin Boyer with Austin Boats and Motors. Appreciate your time. Please feel free to comment below, and we'll look forward to getting connected with you soon. Thank you so much for your time.